All right, Shalom, starting today with the Book of Maccabees, all right. And, you know, it basically was in the 1611 King James Bible, all right. So it actually was a part of the Bible, all right, of the original Bible, what the Israelites use today, all right. And, you know, it's the best translation out there, all right. All right, first off, my English is not perfect, all right, but, you know, I try my best and, you know, at least, all right, you understand what I'm saying, all right, and, you know, let's start, all right. This is First Maccabees, chapter 1, and it happened after that Alexander, son of Philip, the Macedonian, who came out of the land of Kittim, had smitten Darius, king of the Persians and Medes. All right, the Persians are today the Elamites, you know, Elamites, that he reigned in his stead, the first over Greece, and made many wars, and won many strongholds, and slew the kings of the earth, and went to the ends of the earth, and took spoils of many nations, insomuch that the earth was quiet before him, whereupon he was exalted, and his heart was lifted up. And he gathered a mighty strong host and ruled over countries and nations and kings who became tributaries unto him. And after these things he fell sick and perceived that he should die. Wherefore he called his servants, such as were honorable, Salak, and had been brought up with him from his youth, and parted his kingdom among them while he was yet alive. So Alexander went 12 years, and then he died. Or then died. And his servants bare rule every one in his place. And after his death, they all put crowns upon themselves, so that their sons after them many years, and evils were multiplied in the earth. And there came out of them a wicked root, Antiochus, surnamed Epiphanes, or right, son of Antiochus the king, who had been an hostage at Rome, and he reigned in the 137th year of the kingdom of the Greeks. In those days, so you know, I don't do any commentary, all right, you know, while I'm reading this, but you know, maybe after I'm finished, you know, let's see. In those days went there out of Israel wicked men, who pursued at many, saying, let us go and make a covenant with the heathen, you see, that are round about us, for since we departed from them, we have had much sorrow. So this device pleased them well. Then certain of the people were so forward herein, all right, that they went to the king, who gave them license to do after the ordinances of the heathen. Whereupon they built a place, exercised at Jerusalem according to the customs of the heathen, and made themselves uncircumcised, and forsook the holy covenant, and joined themselves to the heathen, and were sold to do mischief. Alright. Now when the kingdom was established before Antiochus, he thought to reign over Egypt, that he might have the dominion of two realms. Wherefore he entered into Egypt with a great multitude, with chariots and elephants and horsemen and a great navy, and made war against Ptolemy, right, king of Egypt. But Ptolemy was afraid of him and fled, and many were wounded to death. Thus they got the strong cities in the land of Egypt, and he took the spoils thereof. And after that Antiochus had smitten Egypt, he returned again in the 143rd year, and went up against Israel and Jerusalem with a great multitude, and entered partly into the sanctuary, and took away the golden altar, and the candlestick of light, and all the vessels thereof, and the table of the shewbread, and the pouring vessels, and the vials, and the censers of gold, and the veil, and the crown and the golden ornaments that were before the temple, all which he pulled off. He took also the silver and the gold and the precious vessels. Also he took the hidden treasures which he found. And when he had taken all away, he went into his own land, having made a great massacre, right, and spoken very proudly. Therefore there was a great mourning in Israel, in every place where they were, so that the princes and elders mourned, the virgins and young men were made feeble, and the beauty of women was changed. Every bridegroom took up lamentation, and she that sat in the marriage chamber was in heaviness. The land also was moved for the inhabitants thereof, and all the house of Jacob was covered with confusion. And after 2 years fully expired, the king sent his chief collector of tribute unto the cities of Judah, who came unto Jerusalem with a great multitude, and spake peaceable words unto them. But all was deceit, for when they had given him credence, he fell suddenly upon the city, and smote it very sore, and destroyed much people of Israel. And when he had taken the spoils of the city, he set it on fire, and pulled down the houses and walls thereof on every side. But the woman and children took they captive, and possessed the cattle. Then builded they the city of David with a great and strong wall, and with mighty towers, and made it a stronghold for them. And they put therein a sinful nation, wicked men, and fortified themselves therein. They stored it also with armor and victuals, and when they had gathered together the spoils of Jerusalem, they laid them up there, and so they became a sore snare. For it was a place to lie and wait against the sanctuary, and an evil adversary to Israel. Thus they shed innocent blood on every side of the sanctuary, and defiled it, insomuch that the inhabitants of Jerusalem, all right, fled because of them. Whereupon the city was made an habitation of strangers, and became strange to those that were born in her, and her own children left her. Her sanctuary was laid waste like a wilderness, her feasts were turned into mourning, her sabbaths into reproach, her honor into contempt. As had been her glory, so was her dishonor increased, and her excellency was turned into mourning. Moreover, King Antiochus wrote to his whole kingdom that all should be one people, and every one should leave his laws, so all the heathen agreed according to the commandment of the king. Yea, many also the Israelites consented to his religion, and sacrificed unto idols, and profaned the Sabbath. For the king had sent letters by messengers unto Jerusalem and the cities of Judah, that they should follow the strange laws of the land, and forbid burnt offerings and sacrifice and drink offerings in the temple, Salak, and they that and that they should profane the Sabbaths and festival days, and pollute the sanctuary and holy people, set up altars and groves and chapels of idols, and sacrifice swine's flesh and unclean beasts, that they should also leave their children uncircumcised, and make their souls abominable with all manner of uncleanness and profanation, to the end they might forget the law and change all the ordinances. And whosoever would not do according to the commandment of the king, he said he should die. In the selfsame manner wrote he to his whole kingdom, and appointed overseers over all the people, commanding the cities of Judah to sacrifice city by city. Then many of the people were gathered unto them, to wit every one that forsook the law, and so they committed evils in the land, and drove the Israelites into secret places, even wheresoever they could flee for sojourn. Now the 15th day of the month Kislew, in Hebrew, it's called like that. In the 145th year, they set up the abomination of desolation upon the altar, and builded idol altars throughout the cities of Judah on every side, and burned incense at the doors, of their houses and in the streets. And when they had rent in pieces the books of the law which they found, they burnt them with fire. And whosoever was found with any the book of the testament, or if any committed to the law the king's commandment, was that they should put him to death. Thus did they by their authority unto the Israelites every month, to as many as were found in the cities. Now the 5th and 20th day of the month they did sacrifice upon the idol altar, which was upon the altar of God, at which time, according to the commandment, they put to death certain women, that they caused their children to be circumcised. And they hanged the infants about their necks, and riffled their houses, and slew them that had circumcised them. Howbeit many in Israel were wholly reserved and circumcised in themselves, not to eat any unclean thing. Wherefore, they were to die, that they might not be defiled with meats, all right, and that they might not profane the holy covenant. So then they died, all right. And there was a great wrath upon Israel. Chapter 2. In those days, so, you know, just thinking about little commentary, but I think, you know, this is just a reading lesson, all right. You know, maybe one chapter, all right, and then maybe some, you know, just a few couple words, all right. In those days arose Mattathias, the son of John, the son of Simeon, a priest of the sons of Joab, all right, from Jerusalem, and dwelt in Modin. And he had 5 sons, Jonan called Kiddes, Simeon called Tassi, Judas, who was called Maccabeus, Eleazar called Aphron, and Jonathan, all right, whose surname was Aphus. And when he saw the blasphemies that were committed in Judah and Jerusalem, he said, "Who is me? Who is always destruction, all right? Wherefore was I born to see this misery of my people and of the holy city, and to dwell there when it was delivered into the hand of the enemy? And the sanctuary into the hand of strangers. Her temple is become as man without glory. Her glorious vessels are carried away into captivity. Her infants are slain in the streets, her young men with the sword of the enemy. What nation had not had a part in her kingdom and gotten of her spoils? All her ornaments are taken away of free woman. She is become a bond slave. And behold, our sanctuary, even our beauty of and our glory is laid waste, and the Gentiles have profaned it. To what end thereof shall we live any longer?" Then Mattathias and his sons went their clothes and put on sackcloth, all right, and mourned where we saw. In the meanwhile, the king's officers, such as compelled the people to revolt, came into the city Modin to make them sacrifice. And when many of Israel came unto them, Mattathias also and his sons came together. Then answered the king's officers, and said to Mattathias on this wise: "Thou art a ruler, all right, and an honorable and great man in the city, and strengthen it, all right, with sons and brethren. Now therefore come thou first, and fulfill the king's commandment, like as well the heathen have done, yea, and the men of Judah also, and such as remain at Jerusalem. So shalt thou and the house be in the number of the king's friends, and thou and thy children shall be honored with silver and gold, and many rewards." Then Mattathias answered and spake with a loud voice: "Thou, all the nations that are under the king's dominion, obey him, and fall away every one from the religion of their fathers, and give consent to his commandments. Yet will I and my sons and my brethren walk in the covenant of our fathers. God forbid that we should forsake the law and the ordinances. We will not hearken to the king's words to go from our religion, either on the right or the left." Now when he had left speaking these words, there came on the one of the Jews in the sight of all to sacrifice on the altar which was at Modin, according to the king's commandment. Which thing, when Mattathias saw, he was inflamed with zeal, and his veins trembled, neither could he forbear to shew his anger according to judgment. Wherefore he went and slew him upon the altar. Also the king's commissioner, who compelled man to sacrifice he killed at the time and the altar he pulled down. Thus dealt he zealously aright for the law of God, like as Phinehas did unto Zimri the son of Salom. And Mattathias cried throughout the city with a loud voice, saying, Whosoever is zealous of the law and maintained the covenant, let him follow me. So he and his sons fled into the mountains and left all that ever they had in the city. Then many that sought after justice and judgment went down into the wilderness to dwell there, both they and their children and their wives and their cattle, because afflictions increased so upon them. Now when it was told the king's servants and the host that was at Jerusalem in the city of David, that certain men who had broken the king's commandment were gone down into the secret places in the wilderness, they pursued after them a great number, and having overtaken them, they camped against them and made war against them on the Sabbath day. All right. And they said unto them, Let that which ye have done here hitherto suffice. Come forth and do according to the commandment of the king, and ye shall live. But they said, We will not come forth, neither will we do the king's commandment to profane the Sabbath day. So then they gave them the battle with all speed. Howbeit they answered them not, neither cast they a stone at them, nor stopped the places where they lay hid. Alright. But said, Let us die in all our innocency. Heaven and earth will testify for us that ye put us to death wrongfully. So they rose up against them in battle on the Sabbath, and they slew them with their wives and children and their cattle to the number of a thousand people. Now when Mattathias and his friends understood thereof, they mourned for them right sore. And one of them said to another, If we all do as our brethren have done, and fight not for our lives and laws against the heathen, they will not quickly root us out of the earth. At the time thereof they declared, saying, Whosoever shall come to take battle with us on the Sabbath day, we will fight against him, neither will we die all as our brethren that were murdered in the secret places. Then came there unto him a company of Assyrians, who were mighty men of Israel, even all such as were voluntarily devoted unto the law. Also all they that fled for persecution joined themselves unto them, and were stay unto them. So they joined their forces and smote sinful men in their anger and wicked men in their wrath. But the rest fled to the heathen for sojourn. Then Mattathias and his friends went round about and pulled down the altars, and what children soever they found within the coast of Israel uncircumcised, and those they circumcised valiantly. They pursued it also after the proud men, and the work prospered in their hand. So they recovered the law out of the hand of the Gentiles and out of the hand of kings, neither suffered they the sinner to triumph. Now when the time drew near that Mattathias should die, he said unto his sons, Now had pride and rebuke gotten strength, and the time of destruction and the wrath of indignation. Now therefore, may my sons, be ye zealous for the law, and give your lives for the covenant of your fathers. Call to remembrance what acts our fathers did in their time, so shall ye receive great honor and an everlasting name. Was not Abraham found faithful in temptation, and it was imputed unto him for righteousness? Joseph in the time of his distress kept the commandment and was made lord of Egypt. Phinehas our father, in being zealous and fervent, obtained the covenant of an everlasting priesthood. Jehoshaphat for fulfilling the word was made a judge in Israel. Caleb for hearing witness before the congregation received the heritage of the land. David for being merciful possessed the throne of an everlasting kingdom. Elias for being zealous and fervent for the law was taken up into heaven. Ananias, Azarias, and Misael by believing were saved out of the flame. Daniel for his... So this is actually a good list here, all right? Because, you know, it's actually a good list here, right? delivered from the mouth of lions, Daniel, okay, and he was alone, remember that, all right, and thus consider ye throughout all ages that none that put their trust in him shall be overcome. Fear not then the words of a sinful man, for his glory shall be dung and worms. Today he shall be lifted up, and tomorrow he shall not be found, because he is returned into his dust, and he doubt is come to nothing. Wherefore, ye my sons, be valiant, and shew yourselves men in the behalf of the law, for by it shall ye obtain glory. And behold, I know that your brother Simon is a man of counsel. All right, give ear unto him alway, he shall be a father unto you. As for Judas Maccabeus, he had been mighty and strong even from his youth up, all right? Let him be your captain and fight the battle of the people. Take also unto you all those that observe the law, and avenge ye the wrong of your people. Recompense fully the heathen, and take heed to the commandments of the law. So he blessed them and was gathered to his fathers. And he died in the 146th year. And his sons buried him in the sepulchres of his fathers at Modin, and all Israel made a great lamentation for him. All right. Let's read the third book, all right, and, you know, then we will close out. Then his sons Judas, called Maccabeus, rose up in his stead, and all his brethren helped him, and so did all they that held with his father, and they fought with cheerfulness the battle of Israel. So he gave his people great honor. You know, just a quick commentary, real quick, all right. How should I say? I would say, you know, it's just to keep in remembrance, all right, that these people are actually think, you know, like in these times, all right, especially when it comes to our own people, all right, they still think like, you know, like in this kind of, you know, kind of thinking, all right. Keep that in remembrance, all right. Keep that in mind. You know, no commentary at all, but, you know. So he got his people great honor, and put on a breastplate as a giant, and girt his warlike harness about him, and he made battles, protecting the host with his sword. In his acts he was like a lion and like a lion's whelp, warring for his prey. For he pursued the wicked and sought them out and burnt up those that vexed his people. Wherefore the wicked shrunk for fear of him, and all the workers of iniquity were troubled, because salvation prospered in his hands. In his hand. He grieved also many kings, and made Jacob glad with his acts, and his memorial is blessed forever. Moreover, he went through the cities of Judah, destroying the ungodly out of them. See? And turning away wrath from Israel. Alright. Okay. So that he was renowned unto the uttermost part of the earth. Alright. And he received unto him such as were ready to perish. Then Apollonius, alright, gathered the Gentiles together, and a great host out of Samaria to fight against Israel. Which thing, when Judas perceived, he went forth to meet him, and so he smote him and slew him. Many also fell down slain, but the rest fled. Wherefore Judas took their spoils, and Apollonius swore also, and therewith he fought all his life long. Now when Seron, a prince of the army of Syria, heard say that Judas had gathered unto him a multitude of company of the faithful to go out with him to war, he said, I will get me a name and honor in the kingdom, for I will go fight with Judas and them that are with him to despise the king's commandment. So he made him ready to go up, and there went with him a mighty host of the ungodly to help him, and to be avenged of the children of Israel. And when he came near to the going up of Bethoron, Judas went forth to meet him with a small company, who, when they saw the host coming to meet them, said unto Judas, How shall we be able, being so few, so to fight against so great a multitude? And so strong, seeing we are ready to faint with fasting all this day? Unto whom Judas answered, It is no hard matter for many to be shut up in the hands of a few, and with the God of heaven, it is all one, Selak, to deliver with a great multitude or a small company. For the victory of battle standeth not in the multitude of an host, but strength cometh from heaven. See? They come against us in much pride and iniquity to destroy us and our wives and children and spoil us, and to spoil us. But we fight for our lives and our laws. Wherefore the Lord himself will overthrow them before our face. And as for you, be ye not afraid of them. Now as soon as he had left off speaking, he leaped suddenly upon them. And so Seron and his host was overthrown before him. And they pursued them from the going down of Bethoron unto the plain, where were slain about 800 men of them. And the residue fled into the land of the Philistines. Then began the fear of Judas and his brethren, and an exceeding great dread to fall upon the nations round about them, insomuch as his fame came unto the king, and all nations talked of the battles of Judas. Now when King Antiochus heard these things, he was full of indignation. Wherefore he sent and gathered together all the forces of his realm, even a very strong army. He opened also his treasure and gave his soldiers pay for a year, commanding them to be ready whensoever he should need them. Nevertheless, when he saw that the money of his treasures failed and the tributes in the country were small, because of the dissension and plague which he had brought upon the land in taking away the laws which had been of all time, he feared that he should not be able to bear the charges any longer, nor to have such gifts to give so liberally as he did before, for he had abundant above the kings that were before him. Wherefore, being greatly perplexed in his mind, he determined to go into Persia, there to take the tributes of the countries and to gather much money. So he left Lysias, a nobleman and one of the blood royal, to oversee the affairs of a king from the river Euphrates unto the borders of Egypt, and to bring up his son Antiochus until he came again. Moreover, he delivered unto him the half of his forces and the elephants, and gave him charge of all things that he would have done, as also concerning them that dwelt in Judah and Jerusalem, to wit, that he should send an army against him to destroy and root out the strength of Israel and the remnant of Jerusalem, and to take away the memorial from that place. Selak, and that he should place strangers in all their quarters and divide the land by lot. So the king took the half of the forces that remained and departed from Antioch, his royal city, the 147th year. And having passed the river Euphrates, he went to high countries. Then Lysias chose Ptolemy, all right, the son of Dorymenus, Nicanor, and Gorgias, mighty men of king's friends, of the king's friends. And with them he sent 40,000 footmen and 7,000 horsemen to go into the land of Judah and to destroy it, as the king commanded. So they went forth with all their power and came and pitched by Emers in the plain country. And the merchants of the country, hearing the fame of them, took silver and gold very much with servants, and came into the camp to buy the children of Israel for slaves. A power also of Syria and of the land of the Philistines joined themselves unto them. Now when Judas and his brethren saw that miseries were multiplied and that the forces did encamped themselves in their borders, for they knew how the king had given commandment to destroy the people and utterly abolish them. All right, abolish them. They said one to another, "Let us restore the decayed fortune of our people, Let us fight for our people and the sanctuary. All right. Then was the congregation gathered together, that they might be ready for battle, and that they might pray and ask mercy and compassion. Now Jerusalem lay void as a wilderness, right? There was none of her children that went in or out. The sanctuary also was torn down, and aliens kept the stronghold. The heathen had their habitation in that place, and joy was taken from Jacob, and the pipe with the harp ceased. All right. Wherefore the Israelites assembled themselves together and came to Mashpah over against Jerusalem, for in Mashpah, the place where they prayed aforetime in Israel. Then they fasted that day and put on sackcloth and cast ashes upon their heads and rent their clothes and laid open the book of the law wherein the heathen had sought to paint the likeness of their images, you see, so, you know, aka Edomite Jesus, all right. They brought also the priest's garments and the first fruits and the tithes, and the Nazarites they stirred up who had accomplished their days. Then cried they with a loud voice toward heaven, saying, what shall we do with these, and whither shall we carry them away? For the sanctuary is torn down and profaned, and their priests are in heaviness and brought low. And lo, the heathen are assembled together against us to destroy us. What things they imagine against us thou knowest. How shall we be able to stand against them, except thou, O Yahweh, be our help? Then sounded they with trumpets and cried with a loud voice. And after this Judah ordained captains over the people, even captains over thousands and over hundreds and over fifties and over tens. But as for such as were building houses, or had betrothed wives, or were planting vineyards, or were fearful, those he commanded that they should return, every man to his own house, according to the law. So the camp removed and pitched upon the south side of Emmaus. And Judas said, arm yourselves and be valiant men. All right? Or valiant men. Valiant men. And see that ye be in readiness against the morning, that ye may fight with these nations that are assembled together against us to destroy us and our sanctuary. For it is better for us to die in battle than to behold the calamities of our people and our sanctuary. Nevertheless, as the will of God is in heaven, so let him do. All right. And, you know, this is basically, you know, the first two chapters, all right, of the first book of Maccabees, all right. And, you know, I have not that much to say, but you know, they removed it out of the Bible, all right, because it was part of the Bible. And you know, it basically exposes, all right, the Israelite and Edomite connection, all right, to basically, you know, destroy for the Israelites, all right, their own people, all right, and for the Edomites, their twin brother, all right, you see. So basically, you know, this is Rome all over again, all right, you know, with the difference that we will get spiritual powers, of course, but basically, you know, the two thirds, all right, they will be in that same mindset, all right, and the Edomites also, and the other heathens, all right, you know, and, you know, this man here, all right, that fought against the, even the wicked Israelites, all right, that persecuted them, basically, you know, these are our, not idols, you know, but these are our great men, all right, and you heard it, all right, there was the list of the our forefathers, all right, of the patriarchs, all right, and, you know, basically, all right, you know, this is what everybody will be tried, all right? And basically you have like these men that are that were before us, all right? And they are basically at one part they are back today, all right, as some other people, but you know they were these men in these ancient times. And you know, and the other part is basically in heaven right now, all right, in the spiritual heaven, all right, because nobody is saved yet, all right, especially not them Christians, all right. But you know, basically, you should read this, all right, and you know, if you received some edification out of it, all right, that's good, because you know, sometimes you know, you may want to hear it from an Israelite brother, all right. So you know, there you go, all right, because I will actually, you know, finish it to the 16th chapter, all right. You know, because you know, I can't hear this. I once heard this, all right, and you know, it's not that, you know, I don't know, all right, was not that deep, but you know, so I decided to pretty much read it for myself, all right, and read it for you, right? So I hope you know that this is some kind of edification for you, all right. And with that, all right, Brak der Yahweh, all right, and keep the faith, all right, because it all will come down to faith, all right, it all will come down to faith, all right, at the end, you know. And the 144,000 are sealed, all right, and with that, you know, we call it a day, all right. Shalom.